Hi, welcome to the Brooklyn Coffee and Tea House. How can I help you?
I'll just have a large coffee, please. Perfect. Oh, thank you.
Hi, welcome to the Brooklyn Coffee Tea House. How can I help you?
A large tea, please. There you go. Thanks. Hi, how are you? How are you?
I'm okay. Actually, I'm better than okay. I feel like me again.
That's wonderful.
I finally did it. After 6 months of separation, I filed for divorce. I didn't think this would be happening.
Didn't think what?
I guess when I said I do, I thought it would last forever. But here I am, single, free again.
You're better off, really. You deserve someone better who understands you.
Oh, Warren wasn't that bad. He could be really sweet, believe it or not, but just not often enough these last few years.
I get that. Alfonso and I barely talked before the divorce. Barely. I guess you never really forgave me. Greta, you've been such a great friend. We have common interests, love of the arts, coffee shops.
It's my pleasure. Unfortunately, I guess this is gonna cost me a lot. May need to get a small place, but I'll be fine.
I should probably say what I came to say. I need to break things off.
Why? Is it Al?
No, it's me. It's just, it's been wonderful. It's been really wonderful. It's too soon.
I'm sorry you feel that way. But of course I understand. You're right. Too soon.
I am so sorry. I mean, if only—
Don't. Please don't. I'm sorry too.
I should really go. I really do care about you, Greta.
Hello?
Hello, Greta. It's Marlene. How are you?
Marlene, it's been a while.
Yeah, it has.
I'm sorry. I'm good. I'm fine. How have you been?
Not too bad. Thinking of you. I was wondering if we could meet. You know, catch up. Talk.
Sure, I could do that. Where?
Anywhere.
Okay. How about the Brooklyn? I can be there in 20 minutes.
Great. See you soon. Hi, I'll take a green tea.
That's gonna be $2.
Hi.
Hi, how can I help you?
I'll just have a coffee, please.
It's gonna be $2.
Thanks. It's good to see you.
Yeah. There's so much to talk about. I missed you so much. There were so many times I wanted to call, and it just never seemed like the right time, and I didn't know if you'd respond. Anyway, I didn't, and you look great.
Thank you. So do you.
Thanks. I guess I should say what I came here to say. It's just so good to see you. I missed you so much. And there's so much to talk about.
You said that.
Yeah, I'm sorry. What I wanted to say was... Oh, sorry.
Hello? Yeah, sure, I can meet you for dinner later. Mm-hmm. Okay. Love you. Sorry about that. So, tell me.
It's just so good to see you. Always regret that day. I finally had her, my best friend Greta. A loveless marriage and bitter divorce had left me angry and cynical. I always thought that Al was the kind of man I wanted to be married to, but we were worlds apart. He was having an affair, a younger woman, of course. I was stunned. He always played by the rules. Good job. Watch football on Sundays with his buddies, but I tried to get him to want more. To be interested in the things that are important to me. In the beginning, he would come see me perform, but he'd sit there on his phone. There was always a complaint or a snide remark afterwards. I remember this one play. I was so proud. I just really wanted him to see it. Maybe he'd finally understand me. He didn't show up. I knew it was punishment. I'd never been unfaithful before, and never again since. It was just that one beautiful night backstage. After that, he wouldn't even talk to me about theater. That's what's so great about Greta. She was always so supportive. She was at that show. I didn't even know until she came to my dressing room afterwards. I could always count on her.
It's been a year. 1 year since leaving an unhappy marriage. An abusive one to Warren. After 12 years, I'd had enough. It took too much for too long. He could be very cold at times. I remember he would embarrass me at parties. Treat me like I was nothing. Like I was his own little jester. I never understood why. Maybe it was his father's influence. He had always been that way to him. But there was always Marlene. She understood me. I remember we would bore him in at parties talking about Van Gogh and Goya, philosophy of Aristotle and Nietzsche, and of course the theater. But she was someone else's woman and I belonged to another man. We were forbidden fruit, spoiling away. Maybe we should do this another time.
Yeah, you know, I was just dropping by. Greta,
Take care, Marlene.
You too, Greta.